It's Sunday. I hope you're up. I hope you have your coffee. You're in your underwears. You're doing your little dance like this, dancing to the TV. The Chromecast thus. It's the Beard in the Mall. Hello.
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 Woo. What's
I am Save Yourself the Beard.
And I'm Gio on the Bowl.
And welcome to another live ass show.
Live.
As live as it could be.
Live
from here to here, because that's all you see. Yeah. You don't see the booty shakes or nothing like that. You don't see the twerking.
This episode will be previously recorded.
Previously.
However, we will post it on Sunday at 12 o'clock Eastern time. 12 o'clock.
Eastern. If you don't know what time that is, that's where you live now.
Google it. It's on Facebook Live and YouTube Live.
Facebook Live and YouTube Live.
Soon to be going to Periscope Live.
What? Twitter Live?
Instagram Live. And MySpace Live. And Mi Gente Live.
Hold on, there's still a MySpace?
Friendster Live.
Man, I deleted my MySpace.
Yeah, cheers, bro.
Oh, cheers.
Cheers. We're drinking juice. Grape juice.
Drinking on gin and juice. Laid back.
Listen, we're drinking grape juice and apple juice.
Okay. This is actually apple juice.
Okay.
With lime.
So I hope y'all doing good. Hope y'all had a good week.
And alcohol.
And we just, you know, we're here to have a show with y'all and bond with y'all. And we encourage y'all to comment down below, give us some feedback, interact, all that.
And remember, this is a social media network, so liking, sharing, and commenting is greatly appreciated.
Yes, it's encouraged.
It's encouraged. Just do it. Just give it to all your friends.
So let's get into the show. Let's get into the show, man.
Let's get into positive. Oh, I have something for positive vibes.
We got a lot of stuff to go on. Yeah, we got positive vibes here. Positive vibes.
Let's go to positive vibes.
It's first on the docket. On the docket.
Positive vibes.
On the docket.
Real quick, it's going to be a short and easy. Life is 10% what happens to you and 90% of how you react to it. So stop reacting like a little and just do what you got to do and make life happen for real.
No, but that's very true. Because a lot of the time, you think it's the other way around. 90% of what happens to you and 10% of how you react, it's the other way around.
It's the other way around because the action of something happening to you is just so minute. It's just how you take it.
That's how you process it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So
some people can't handle that, though.
But you know what I heard one time? It was from, I think it was J. Cole, that said that stress and pressure.
The what?
Stress and pressure.
All right.
Feels the same to everybody. So no matter what, yes, there might be arguably degrees of stress and pressure, mm-hmm. but... if no matter the situation, so if you put a person in a different country, a different place, the stress, how you react to the stress, how you process the stress, is the same to everybody.
Sure.
So it feels the same, but it's how you react to it is different. So yeah.
I like that.
So stress and pressure feels the same to everybody. Remember that. It doesn't matter something, because some people go, you don't know my situation. My situation is different. It's more pressure.
Man,
it's more stress.
No.
Nah, man, stress is stress, man.
Stress is exactly.
So if you learn how to deal with stress, and you learn how to deal with adversity, you can deal with all stress.
Good example.
And all adversity.
Spider-Man. When his uncle died, he could have just went into his room and crawled up and made a web and just stayed there. But no, what he did, he made a suit and swam to New York and became a superhero.
Yeah, I never thought that I would see philosophical meaning in Spider-Man. That was deep, bro. I like that.
Real deep, bro.
So, the other positive vibes we had was on the WBC, the World Baseball Classic. The World Baseball Classic.
Oh, you mean that debacle?
The debacle.
The debacle.
Okay, so for those...
Hold on. Let me just show you what the score was and what happened this past week.
Okay.
When DR went against Puerto Rico.
DR versus Puerto Rico in the World Baseball Classic baseball tournament. This is a tournament that happens every 2 years, before the actual baseball season.
So, let's just show you... one thing.
Okay, he's mad because DR lost. I'm Puerto Rican, he's Dominican.
See, look.
And Puerto Rico won.
You know what's funny? I had to score backwards.
Yeah, you did have to score. That's why I was wondering what the heck you were doing, bro. Jesus, man. Where's your marker?
I don't know where the marker is. Here, but basically, I hate writing. That's why it's not supposed to be this way. Well, basically, DR. Puerto Rico won 3-1. And the MVP on the Puerto Rican team was the umpire. The umpire. The umpire. The umpire. Not none of the players. The umpire was a
That was the MVP.
Yeah. Okay. Look, guys, people of the world, let me show you something. Pitching is pitching. Pitching, when you pitch, is in the square. The catcher sits in the middle.
Did you just draw a strike zone?
I drew a strike zone. The pitcher sits in the middle, and he catches the ball within this square.
The pitcher sits in the middle.
Well, the pitcher, the catcher. Okay. The catcher sits in the middle. The pitcher throws the ball. Now, if it's in here, in this zone, yes, it is a strike. Now, when you throw the ball this way, and this way, out of the damn strike zone, there's something wrong there.
Listen, I didn't watch the game. All I know is that Puerto Rico won, and I texted this guy like at 1 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah, I told you your phone broke. Your phone broke. It cracked.
But it's just funny to me because if you look at Dominican Republic's team, they're just all stars, yo.
Yeah, so I have it right here for you, bro.
Listen, you could blame it on the umpire and the strike zone, but Yo, you got every... This is DR?
This is the DR team.
Bro, you got Jose Batista, Adrian Beltre, bro, Robinson Cano. Come, dude, I don't even have to go down. Nelson Cruz, Bartolo Colon, Johnny Cueto. Dude, come on, man.
That does not matter.
Hold on.
That does not matter. The one important player of your team, the umpire.
The one important team. Yo, 2 years ago, you had... David Ortiz, Big Papi, bro. Come on, man.
You still have him. He's the one that cooked the mango. He cooked the mango and the salami. That's what happened. I think it was a conspiracy. That's what happened. Big Papi cooked too much.
And they got tired.
They got itis. They were laid back the whole time. He wasn't
on the team, but he was the chef in the dugout.
He was the chef in the dugout, He had the fucking longanisa cooking and shit.
Oh my god, that's hilarious.
And every time they messed up, he was throwing the chancleta.
But yo, chime down below, comment down, are you watching the World Baseball Classic? Are you a baseball fan? Who are you going for? Do you think it's even fair, DR versus PR? Because yo, if you look at DR's team, they're stacked.
Of course it's not fair, because the umpire is on your team.
Nah, bro. We gotta find out the umpire's name. If his last name was like Rodriguez, then yeah.
No, I don't know his last name, but it's an actual thing though. I believe, if I'm not mistaken, if it's not fake news, because I ran into a bunch of crazy articles, but he is Puerto Rican. He's of Puerto Rican parents, and apparently he just got his like MLB thing or something.
His license?
Yeah.
Bro, it doesn't matter, bro. Because if you look at your team, I'm telling you, bro, your team's always stacked. No excuse. Fake news. Okay? So, anyway, moving on. Okay.
Man.
Moving on. Okay. We got Deadpool 2. Deadpool 2. I don't know if y'all saw the Deadpool 2 trailer, but it's on Netflix. Not Netflix. YouTube. It's on YouTube. And so it wasn't really a trailer. It was more of a teaser. What is that? Easter egg. It had a bunch of Easter eggs. And Deadpool 2, it wasn't really a trailer. It was more of a comedy sketch. I think it was more like, hey, listen, we're filming. We're thinking about you.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because he actually, if you look at his YouTube, he has a YouTube channel. Ryan Reynolds has a YouTube channel.
Really?
And it has a bunch of like Deadpool like clips I've never seen in my life.
Really?
And so what it was is like he just released it there. It's almost like, hey, we're filming it, but we don't want to release the trailer, so we'll just release something. And it was just a quick like comedy sketch. It was actually pretty funny. It was a comedy sketch.
I guess I didn't like it.
We'll put it in the link down below.
Yeah,
why did you like it?
I was funny, but...
It's not meant to be taken serious, bro.
No, I was with my son, so I couldn't enjoy it. He was looking.
Yeah, but you were distracted.
I was distracted, and then all you see is this scene.
Yeah. So, if you haven't seen it, we'll put it down.
You see Ryan... Well, I'm not gonna ruin it for anybody. Go watch it, and then we'll talk about it later. But you see Ryan.
I'll put it in the link down below. It's a 2 minute thing. It's not a big deal. And I don't want to spoil others, but basically, like
it's just a bunch of Easter eggs. Just go watch it.
Easter egg. He's making fun of other superheroes as he normally does.
We'll give you time. We will not spoil shit until next week.
No, because it's not like it's a movie that came out. You know what I mean?
I still want to spoil it for some people.
He hops into a booth. Someone's getting mugged. Someone's getting mugged.
He said,
not on my watch.
Watch.
Right? And he jumps into a telephone booth, and then he Later on, he's
like, changing.
He's like, why is there a telephone booth in 2017? Anyway,
the whole thing is that.
Yes! He jumps into a telephone booth, but then he's doing a spoof on Superman. He's trying to change. He's like, how does he do it so quick? He's like, I gotta talk to the costume designer. This is so uncomfortable.
Stan Lee comes out.
And then Stan Lee comes out. He's like, not now, Stan Lee. And while he's doing it, he shows his ass and on telephone.
Yes.
It's so funny, man. My son, but again, it's a comedy thing. And he comes out and he does a whole commentary. But
my son asked me, what is he doing? I said, he's a superhero. He's putting on his costume. Yeah, that conversation.
Yeah, he doesn't understand it. How old is your son? Four?
He's four. But he said, Daddy, what is that doing there? Those exact same words. I shit you not.
No, I think you should just say, the answer is, he's Ryan Reynolds.
He's Ryan Reynolds. That's Deadpool. He asked me to watch the first one.
He's a wild card.
Can't do that. No.
So, but it was cute. It was funny. It was cute. It was almost like, you know, little thing there, you know.
Nothing here.
I just totally see myself doing that. Like, if I was in his shoes.
Especially with the character you're playing, though.
Yeah. It's almost like
he embodies that character.
This is what he did, okay? He's not the director. No. He's not the writer. He's not the editor. But he's like, hey, listen. I know we're filming. They're probably filming right now.
Yeah.
I know we're filming. Can we put a trailer out? They're going to go, no. We don't have enough stuff for a trailer. Okay. Can we do a fucking sketch? Can we do something? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So he's just doing something. So let people know, hey, we're doing something.
And I think he has that freedom, too, since he battled so hard to get that out there.
It's his project. It's his baby.
Yep.
So, yeah. So anyway, so moving on. Back to videos and movies. So Dave Chappelle released a trailer. About his comedy special coming out in actually the end of March, and I did a little bit more research. And Dave Chappelle on this trailer, he has recorded two comedy specials already. Yes, he's back, and he's back and better than ever. And it was, of course, it was hilarious. We saw it.
I'll
put it down below in the clips.
He just showed it to me like a few minutes ago, and he was saying something. I'm not gonna ruin it for him. He was saying something. I just spit it out.
He's
Dave Chappelle.
He's so funny.
Spit out my drink. He spit out his drink
in my house.
It went up my nose.
So I got a mop later. But,
it went up my nose about how much I spit.
Funny because now, like, it's almost like, honestly, bro, like, I watched that and almost like, I miss Dave Chappelle.
Is it Chappelle show or Dave Chappelle?
That. I miss Dave Chappelle. Okay.
Stand up.
And look, and like I said, he recorded two already. He sold two to Netflix. Yeah. He's going to record a third one at the end of the year. This is what he said in an interview. But I wanted to kind of bring this up a little bit because it just reminds me, yes, I love Key and Peele. And Dave Chappelle said that if it wasn't for me, there wouldn't be these shows. And these shows mean Key and Peele, Nick Kroll, The Kroll Show.
He crossed that line. He made that.
And all those shows are amazing all in their own right. But when I watch Dave Chappelle and I watch Netflix and I watch like that trailer, I'm almost like, oh my god, I miss that dude. Because to me, that dude, he's our Richard Pryor, man.
Yeah,
he's our like guy.
That's now, generation. I know I do it.
What?
But when the Dave Chappelle show first came out, did you ever catch yourself walking around feeling like doing a Dave Chappelle moment, having a Dave Chappelle moment? And actually going through
it. But that's why it was such a great show.
But going through with it.
What do you mean? What are we talking about? So talking about, what's on your mind?
All right. Let's example. I'm with my brothers. Yeah. We'll come around and be like, hey. Now, how's it going there? And do a little sarcastic, little Dick Chappelle. Okay. And he's be like, yeah, motherfucker.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. Okay, we'll edit that.
It's a kid's show.
It's a family show. And you just look at it, and you're like, nuts, now produce some crazy, crazy shit.
No, some outrageous stuff.
Because
yeah. I think when you watch the Chappelle show, we all see ourselves.
Give your best Dave Chappelle look. I did it.
No, but we all see ourselves in that show, right? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
Is that what you're saying? Yeah. It's relatable, right?
That's right. He's right.
Okay, so.
This is my white Chappelle.
Okay, look. So, I saw Dave Chappelle.
You're correct.
I saw Dave Chappelle in Orlando. He came to Orlando. Okay. I think I almost invited you to that.
You did invite me.
And you didn't come.
I couldn't go.
You flaked.
I couldn't go.
Okay.
This is what, let's clear the air out. I used to be a manager at a wholesale club. I'm not going to give them fame because they suck.
JB's.
J-
Yeah, well, I didn't have no time. You know how
I totally get it. But you're lucky. You're lucky. You know why? Because I really sincerely thought that was going to be the last time he was going to come to Orlando. But it appears so that he's back out of his shell and he's touring
again. He's back from Africa.
He's touring again. And he's doing more comedy. So there's a good chance he might come back to Orlando.
If he comes back to Orlando.
Tampa, I'll drive to Tampa for him.
Let's do this. For every viewer out there that comes to a Dave Chappelle show. If you go to a stand-up and you're one of our viewers and we're going to make a big group. We'll do like a little list. Get a school bus.
Who was at that show?
Check in who was at the show. We all get together. We meet you there. We do like a Facebook check. A check-in.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
We can give out a wristband or a cup.
That's a good idea. Well, okay, hold on. Slow down.
But you're getting me excited.
What I'm getting at is that he's apparently going to do another tour. Because he says he's going to record his... Okay, think about this for a second. I didn't really think about... I was going to talk about this, but now...
Think about it.
He's going to be recording a special at the end of the year. When you record a special at the end of the year, or a time, you do a tour. Okay? Mm. So, he should be announcing his tour right about now. So when he starts touring, there's a good chance he's gonna come to Orlando, but he might come to Florida.
I've driven to Tampa
for Bill Burr and Jim Brewer. So I'll drive to North Carolina for Dave
Chappelle. Road trip.
Yeah, because think about the point I'm trying to say is that Dave Chappelle to me is a generational comedy.
Yeah.
He's a generational comedian, generational person that it's just once in a lifetime kind of guy. Because before him, there was Eddie Murphy. Eddie Murphy was your 80s, 90s, and he stopped doing comedy, right? He stopped doing stand-up. He's doing movies. But now Dave Chappelle is your 90s, 2000s.
In the early 90s, we had John Leguizamo, though.
No, I'm talking about stand-up.
Oh, stand-up.
Okay, hold on. No,
this is going to touch him.
I see where you're going.
It's a top,
but, I think, just in the comedy debate, I think, same thing with actors. Once in a lifetime generation, there's that one actor. That's just like, yo, that's that dude. Like music, Michael Jackson, that's that dude.
That's that dude.
Right? Before Michael Jackson, you had like Elvis Presley, right?
Johnny Cash,
Bruce Lee, Johnny Cash. These are iconic people that just come. They don't blend in with the rest. You know what I mean? Yeah. I would say Denzel Washington
is this generation.
Tom Hanks. You know, those are people that like.
There's a lot of names.
They just stand out. But what I'm saying is that they stand out above the rest.
Yeah.
So Dave Chappelle. Okay, look, we're gonna touch on. We released a YouTube video on our top 10 comedians. I ran down, and he ran down. And just think about this for a second. When we run down our top 10 comedians that are alive today, they all look up to Dave Chappelle.
True.
Okay. Chris Rock, Kevin Hart. And I've seen video. I'm obsessed with comedy, so I watch YouTube and they'll go, "Hey, who's your favorite comic? Who do you inspire? Who's inspired you? Who do you look up to?" They'll say, "I look up to Dave Chappelle." Dave Chappelle's that dude, bro. He's what you call a comics comic.
He's a comedical genius.
Yeah. He's a comics comic. He's the comic that you like.
Likes him.
Yeah. Like you know, like your favorite, your rapper's favorite rapper. Like you know, they say like that.
So Bill Burr.
Yeah. Bill Burr would be like Dave Chappelle.
I'm trying to pick the whitest guy now.
Wait a second. That's a perfect example. You know why?
Louis C.K.
Hold on. It's a perfect example. You know why? Because Bill Burr was in the Chappelle show.
Oh, she's right.
Yes, exactly. Because Dave Chappelle was that dude.
Louis C.K.
Louis C.K. is another generational dude.
Yeah.
And he sets a trend. You have Louis C.K. on this side, and you have, you know, Dave Chappelle on the side.
Yeah, because Louis C.K. is a drier comedy.
Right, but for every Richard Pryor, you had Jerry Lewis, right?
So you have
your polarizing guys.
I'm trying to play devil's advocate here.
I love it. Because you had your George Carlin and you had, you know,
Carlin and Richard Pryor.
Yeah, Richard Pryor, exactly.
Because Jerry Lewis would have been at that time.
There wasn't like I was saying.
I don't think there was no one.
There wasn't like too much African American or like a Hispanic.
Chaplin.
No, but not like Jerry Lewis. Jerry Lewis, I would say for Jerry Lewis, I would say maybe Gene Wilder or like
Chaplin.
I don't know. Damn.
Watch your fling with anyway,
so that, okay,
there.
We're going to touch. So that reminds us that, you know, believe it or not, I don't know if y'all noticed, but on Facebook, YouTube,
yeah,
we released a video last week.
Top 10 comics.
Top 10 comedians. Top 10 comedians.
Comedians.
Top 10 comedians.
Comedians.
Stand-up comedians and comedic actors.
Yes.
Okay, we ran out top 10.
Two different.
And we did it all time. So all time meaning like dead or alive.
Dead or alive. D-O-A.
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 And we ran down.
And run down.
So we encourage you to, hey, check out the video. It was really fun. We had a great time.
We had a great time. We always have a great time.
Now listen, me as the editor and you know,
it was hard to edit.
It was hard to edit because, man,
we had like an hour.
We had like an hour of stuff.
And we had it out to like 10 minutes.
And we're comedians, so we could talk about it forever, and we did. But I had to condense it.
And we're actually at that point now.
But this is a great topic, yeah, on for a live stream. But at the same time, we want you to just chime down below. Who is your top, maybe top 10 is too much. I was thinking maybe top 10, top 5.
Top 5, this is top 5.
Who's your top 5?
Yeah, do your top 5.
Who's your top 5?
Because it took me very long to cut down my long list into those 10.
No, because, you know, you could separate it because, like, for example, top 10, top 5, dead or alive. But if you do alive, maybe you do top 5.
Yeah, top 5.
You know, if you do dead or, like, you know, previous generations, you do top, and you could do another top 5. But we just combined it all because it was just so much. It was so much to touch on. And then, on the description below of the YouTube video, I put all the other comedians that we were unable to mention. Because
we should film a round table of, if you think it's a good idea, let us know.
Give us a thumbs up.
A round table on, we'll get a few people, and we'll do a debate. And between 5 people, we'll pick 5.
You know, I have a good idea. I have a good idea.
You made
a great...
Great point. Let us know. We're doing this for you guys. Let us know.
I like where you're going, and I like this idea. Okay? And this is what we do. We create, right? So, we could do a round table.
Yeah.
I have names already, right? We'll do a round table, and we all get 5. 5 comedians. And you get, like, to argue or debate. Why is your top 5 the best of all time?
We'll get Justin Lawson.
Bunch of people. I'm gonna edit that out. I'm not gonna name people.
No.
But we're gonna get some people, and I think it's a good idea because you can like make your argument of why your top 5 is the top 5 of all time and the best of all time, and it trumps others.
You know why mine's gonna win?
Yeah.
I'm Savior.
Hold on, but you have to also separate comedians versus comedic.
No, we're talking
actors.
About not no actors. Just stay comedians.
Comedic actors versus. Comics.
We're
going to
go straight up stand-up comics. Stand-up comics.
So we'll do stand-up comics, and that's a little different.
Yeah, straight-up comics.
But anyway, just chime down below. We'd love to hear from you. And yes.
All right. We're going to go to our next subject. We're going to stay on the list. The next subject is
Snoop Dogg and Trump.
Snoop!
So do you know, I don't know if y'all heard the controversy, but go ahead, man. Just set it up, man. Set up the subject. I think you're more well versed on this trending topic.
Why? It's because I'm more hood than you?
No, it's not that. It's just maybe you're more. You were more on it than I was. And you actually told me about
this. This social fool right here trying to say my social class in the hood is lower. But you want to know what? Snoop Dogg came back with some gangster stuff on a video. Michael Rappaport on it. I think Michael Rappaport played Trump too, but I couldn't tell because I was just so focused on the Ronald Klump because it was a good video. It was funny. If you look at it, it's about clowns. So it's clowning.
But start from the beginning. So set it up. What's it's a music video. I guess he's releasing a single, an album.
It was
something.
A single, yeah.
And so, but what? How does it start?
Oh, it starts with clowns.
And so everyone's clowns.
Everyone's clowns.
Except for Snoop Dogg.
Except for no Snoop Dogg, Snoop Dogg's not a clown.
He's not a clown.
He had a Snoop Dogg Snoop Loops.
Snoop Loops. Right, and so Mike Rapport in it.
Yeah.
And but they're all like everyone's a clown.
Everyone's a clown. He's trying to make a political statement on what everything's happening.
Which is interesting because he normally doesn't do that.
Basically, his political statement is that. Everything that people are doing nowadays is kind of clowning because cops are clowning on regular people for doing regular things. Michael Rappaport in the video, and spoiler alert if you haven't watched it, Michael Rappaport gets shot. He's a clown. He gets shot by a clown cop, and there was a clown teenager in it. video recording, okay, and puts in a clown tube. So okay, it's the trend of what happens today. We see something, we don't do nothing to help. We record it and try to get the hits.
You get the idea. And so everyone's clowns.
Everyone is
the clown. But at the end, what's the controversy that Trump came out of?
The controversy is that he actually involved a clown Trump, Ronald Klump. And in this video, you see he flashes, and then he finally comes out, and Snoop is in the scene with him, pulls out a gun, and in aims, a clown gun fashion, aims, and goes, bam!
Aims it at the dude.
Aims at his head. And that was a controversy.
And you know what's interesting is that when I read the story and the controversy, I thought, yeah, not only was he aiming it at the president.
I thought he shot him.
I thought he shot him, like, dead.
Yeah.
But when he shoots it, it's like the Joker, like, it shows up, it's bang, like, it shoots out, like, a little curtain thing. It says bang. And then later on, they show...
Like that.
They show... Lord, Jesus Christ. Did you smell that? Did you fart?
I didn't fart.
Bro.
If you farted,
I will stop the recording right now.
Did you fart?
Bro, I didn't fart.
I will own it.
I will tell you!
You better be telling me. This is like the second day in a row.
Is this my couch, motherfucker?
Yo, bro, I swear.
Babe, do we have to get rid of this couch?
No, we need to take it apart so you can clean it.
Yo, it this comes couch apart.
No, hold on.
I can edit this shit out.
Babe, we eat on that couch.
I know. So no, what but I, it's what something I'm like... here's what I think. I think food fell down there somehow, yeah, and an animal or a cockroach or something went in there and is trapped in that. That's what I think.
And he's farting.
No, he's dead.
He's dead.
We need to clean it out.
Where the fuck were we? Donald Trump.
Oh, about...
No! So, he did the... Yes, perfect. He did the bang, right? But he didn't kill him. No. So apparently there was
a... In the later scene, he's in chains trying to smoke some weed.
He's tied up. So he didn't die. But apparently there was a Trump war. So Trump tweeted at him or said something. It was some comment, whatever. And he said something about Snoop Dogg. He's not successful. Yeah. He's not accomplished, whatever. The point
exact
is...
Exact thing. He was like fading Snoop in his career.
Yes. Now, okay, look.
He's...
But here's the thing.
Trump's a clown, first of all.
Here's the thing.
Trump is a clown.
Now, granted, that's where the video comes from. But what does Trump... If you're the president of the United States, aren't you a little more busy... They don't have to deal with or
how
address.
Much, no, what gets to me is
dogs.
How much
video?
Criticism has the previous presidents? Not Obama. Not just look how much bad press and bad SNL skits and bad comments the Bush got.
Of course,
younger Bush.
Of course,
but he didn't go on tweet, and he had Twitter in that time.
Yeah, exactly.
Bill Clinton didn't go and put out a letter to the union. Even after he got caught with Monica Lewinsky,
yeah,
the older Bush didn't get, you know, put a letter out or anything. Obama didn't do anything on Twitter as well.
He enjoyed it. He made fun of it. Exactly. He even had Key and Peele. Remember he
did? Yeah, he had Luther.
They do the angry translator. He brought him onto the
president we have today has an issue with criticism.
But that alarms me because if you're the president, right, you're the leader of the free world, and you're so busy with so much stuff, when do you have time to comment on Saturday Night Live, Spicer, Alec Baldwin?
I mean,
he's spending his time on Snoop Dogg. In my theory, like, you would think that Snoop Dogg's over here, and you're like, you're the leader of the free world. You're like the accomplished president. People voted for you.
Unfortunately, I'm going to show you how this totem pole currently is.
Break it down,
bro. Alright?
Break it down.
Unfortunately, Trump right now is over here. And everyone else, celebrity-wise, is right here under Trump. I don't know if you can see that.
Tilt it forward and back.
Right there, they got it. Trump, yeah, celebrities. And then over here is the rest of society. So if I tweet,
what do they call that thing? That poll?
Nothing happens. The totem pole. Mm-hmm. If I tweet, nothing happens. But if this class over here that has been very loud about Trump Trump gets like hurt because he himself is a celebrity.
Approval rating. His approval rating is
low.
It's low. It's dropping.
It's like what, 30?
So it's 30. It's exactly. It's 30%. So his approval rating.
30%.
So all the people. So here's what's happening. We should totally do this on camera.
Yo, my uncle on Viagra got a better approving rate than Trump.
Hold on. What happens is, because, look, if your approval rating is at 30%, right?
Yeah.
That means that in when did we vote for this motherfucker? In November, right?
In November. 2 months.
In November, the approval rating was here. Let's give him 80%, right? Let's give him 80%.
Why be so generous?
Let's say, hold on.
Because he started with only 54.
Because he won, okay? Whatever.
Look, I'm listening.
Look. He started with 80% approval rating, or whatever, or a majority vote, right? So he's up there, right? So at November, when this shit came in, and he came in January. Hold on, show that later. Hold on. When the January popped in, and he pulled. Remember that first week? That first week with the ban and the change and the walk in the whole.
No.
Thing. So this is.
The first week was the Dakota Pipeline shit.
Okay. But this is the people that voted for him.
Yeah.
Okay. Trump, yes. And then this is January, like, 19th. When he came into the presidency, they go, what the fuck? What's wrong with this dude? What? We voted for this dude? He's doing what? He said what? He tweeted what? Snoop Dogg? What the? Spicer? Alec Baldwin? Like, yo, he just... And it, no. So the shit plummeted.
I read an article today.
It plummeted.
Of a Trump supporter who thought he was going to get free healthcare, that he is so distraught right now.
By Trump care.
Trump care. Listen what Trump care did. Everyone thought Obamacare was bad. Trump care, 14 million people are not going to have insurance.
You know what it's called? Trump don't care.
Trump don't care.
It's called exactly. Trump don't care.
14 million of you people that decided Trump was a better president are not going to have insurance.
So all the people voted, they're like, yeah, Trump's amazing.
Yeah.
Trump don't care? What?
Who gonna buy my cancer
medicine? What? I gotta pay for shit? Like, you
what?
Know, that's what happens. Show them the graph. Show them the
man, this is the graph. This is the approval rating.
This is from CNN, okay? This is a CNN.
It's fake news.
Fake news.
Fake.
This is the, fake. Look, this is the realest it can get, okay? This is from Savier Google, okay? And this is the approval rating, okay? This is real time.
Look,
we don't pull punches here.
No pulling.
It's highfalutin.
Okay, highfalutin.
This is real special effects.
Real special effects.
This is the Trump approval rating.
The Trump approval rating.
I'm messing. This is Trump approval rating.
Oh.
Trump approval rating.
I can't write.
I put three M's in that motherfucker.
But listen.
This is Trump approval rating.
Listen. Okay? I don't get this whole Trump thing, but he needs to let go of a lot of things. Everything celebrities do, let it go. What you need to concentrate on is your approval rating and seeing what is supposed to be done right to the country. Because eventually, you know, it's going to come back on him.
Like, I get if you're the president and, you know, you got a lot of stuff to take care of. Mm-hmm. But, bro, stop paying attention to Snoop Dogg.
He was high when he wrote that shit.
In the grand scheme of things. Who is Snoop Dogg?
Who directed it?
Who, like, you know what I'm saying? If you're going president.
Who wrote the skit to that one?
Be the president. Do what you gotta do.
Be a POTUS.
Yo, I better hope I don't catch Trump around my waist, son.
What you gonna do?
Jab that nigga in the face.
Get jab, Trump. You know how much Secret Service he got?
Yeah, I'm gonna edit that because I'm gonna get arrested.
No, okay. You know what? We can't get arrested and we fall under the First Amendment right.
No, because that's what I'm saying. That's going back to the thing. You can't. So a lot of people are chiming in. They're like, "Yo, bro, you can't point a fucking gun to the president."
He didn't. It was a clown.
Okay, I understand, but you get what, I'm saying. I think Ice Cube, Ice-T, all the rap dudes was like, "You can't do that."
Yes, you can't.
And you know what's funny is that that's coming from Ice Cube.
Yeah.
The dude that said, "Fuck the police."
You can't edit that
out. He said, I'll edit the F word.
It's bleep.
The guy that said at the police said, you can't point a gun to the president. And I get it, but because he's making, like, you know, ride-along movies now. But if it's fight movies,
he's worried about his brand.
No, 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 I get it.
Let's talk
to him. Back in the day, you were that dude.
Let's talk to Young Thug. Let's see what he say. Yeah. Little Wayne. Little Wayne washed down too.
But anyway.
Anyways, but yo, let's wrap this up.
We 40 minutes in.
We're editing. Anyways, ready? Let's wrap this up. All you guys out there, Trump, get with Dave Chappelle. Dave Chappelle will give you great advice.
Dave Chappelle make you smile.
Dave Chappelle will give you great advice.
What are you talking about?
You give Trump great advice. Dave Chappelle should be on the advisory team.
Dave Chappelle wouldn't want to do anything with Trump.
But if Steve Harvey did it, he can do it.
Steve Harvey ain't do nothing. They had a meeting, but it doesn't mean they're best friends.
We need a bipartisan advisor. Dave Chappelle should be a bipartisan advisor. Anyways.
This guy's using big words now.
Bipartisan advisor.
Let's do the outro. We need an outro.
We need an outro. Ready?
Killing all these bitches. Adios, adios.
DR is going to be PR again. Anyways.
No.
Everyone out there, remember, this is a social media network. Please like, share, and subscribe. And share with your friends, because I know you liked it, because you watched the whole damn thing if you're watching this at the moment.
Yeah, share, like, subscribe, comment, all that. And we would love to hear from you. And, yes. And thank you so much for your support.
And give a lot of sad faces if you think Gio ugly as shit.
Nah, give me thumbs up.